The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in March of 1968 in San Francisco.
Maya Saptamana Pratha Yugam Janyan Madhasaya Akhamsang Samagramam So this yoga system, Krishna consciousness yoga system, is to begin with developing attachment for Krishna. And the process of developing attachment, I have already explained to you for this last meeting. So, for the beginners, attachment for God, everyone, even in the lowest stage, he has to admit the greatness of the Supreme Lord. God is great. There is no doubt about it. Everyone, even in the lowest status of life, he can admit. I don't speak of the animals. Animals, they have no sense of God. I am speaking of the human being. There are different grades of human civilization. The highest type of civilization and the lowest aboriginal. But everyone of them has got a sense of God. That is there. This is the special prerogative of human beings. Not that only the civilized man, perhaps you know all when you came here from European country in America, the red Indians, they are considered as aboriginal, but still they had some religion, they had some conception of God. So, God is great, that is admitted by the human civilization. Now, what is that greatness? Generally, when we speak of greatness, we think of the greatness of the sky. That is a simple example how thing can be as great as the sky. But in the sky, you have no perception. As there is development of these material elements from finer existential form to grosser form, and the grosser form become tangible for our understanding. Similarly, in every religion and in every society, the greatness of God is admitted. But how that greatness becomes tangible, that you can find in Bhagavad Gita. Suppose you have got conception of a sky, but you cannot have a definite idea of the greatness of sky, because your experience and knowledge is gathered by sense perception. In the sky, there is no sense perception. Just like you are sitting in this room, within this room there is sky, but we cannot understand the sky. But if we try to understand this table, we can at once understand. Because in the table, if I touch, I feel the hardness, the perception is there. My knowledge can receive that it is a hard table. But if I speak to about sky, I cannot get any direct perception. Therefore, simply understanding of greatness of God is not all. That is the beginning of attachment. God is great. But you have to develop your attachment to the fullest extent. And that is love of God. You cannot love sky. That is not possible. If I say you love sky, so you say, how to love sky? I want a tangible thing. I want a boy, I want a girl, then I can love. How I can love sky? So simply understanding of greatness is not all. Then from the development of from the idea of sky, there is next development is air. In the air, you can perceive something. When the air is blowing, you can at least have some touch sensation. So, as in the material world, from the sky develops the air, from air develops the fire, electricity, and from electricity or fire develops the water, and from water develops this land. When it comes to the land, you can understand something very tangible. Similarly, greatness of God has to be developed out from greatness of God, the idea of greatness. The sense of service must develop. God is so great, so I must render some service to God. This sense of service is further development. Just like from the sky, the air develops, similarly, from the idea of greatness of God, the sense of service develops. Because I am serving somebody great, I go to some office because he provides me, the proprietor gives me some salary, therefore he is greater than me, I render service in exchange of something given by him. So God is so great, in the Vedic literature it is found that eka bahunan vidudhati kama, that one great supreme living being, he supplies all the necessities of all other small living beings. We are all small living beings. And Krishna, as the supreme Lord, is the greatest living being. He is also a living being, just like us. The other day I explained that man is made after God. Not that God is made after man. Don't think that because I have got two hands, two legs, one head, therefore I have created a Krishna who has got two hands, two legs, two heads. No. That is not the fact. Actually, because Krishna has got two legs, two hands, one head, therefore you have also one. So, God is great. And I am dependent. So, man's sense of love has to be developed. We must accept that God is great. He is supplying our necessities. Why not render some service in gratitude? Is there any harm? Suppose somebody is always supplying you everything. Don't you think your gratitude to render some service to him If you develop that sense of gratitude, well, that is further development, attachment. Service. Now, that service has again to be further developed. How this to be developed? Just like service to a friend. A friend does not demand service. Just like master, he demands service, you must do it. But friend does not demand service, but his friend renders service voluntarily. Can I supply you this, my dear friend? Oh, friend, yes, why not? That means voluntary service. More intimate. That is further development. That friendly service, one sort of friendship is with awe and veneration. Just like if you have a very rich friend, you cannot talk with him so frankly, although he is he is your intimate friend. But a friend in the same status, you can talk with him very freely. Similarly, we can develop friendship with God in two stages. The first stage is with awe and veneration. Oh, God is so great. God is supplying us so many things. As in gratitude I must serve it. Or He is my well-wisher, He is my friend. But if you further development your friendship, just like Arjuna developed friendship with Krishna. When he saw Krishna in his supreme universal form, he said, my dear Krishna, I have talked with you as a friend. I have insulted you in so many ways. Friends and friends sometimes they talk in insulting tones. But that is not insult, that is pleasure. Similarly, Arjuna also talks to Krishna in so many insulting tones. But when he saw that, oh, here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he was afraid. So, friendship, then further development of service is to accept the Supreme Lord as Son. When I get somebody as my son, the full service is there from the beginning of his life. So similarly, as the subtler form of elements develop into grosser forms, from sky to air, from air to fire, from fire to water, from water to land, similarly, the attachment of Krishna begins to develop from the sense of greatness. God is great, then God is master, then God is friend, and then God is my son, and then God is my lover. In the lover stage, there are all other elements. When you love somebody, then there is loving element, and there is paternal element, there is friendship element, there is master and servant element, and there is greatness element. Therefore, in the sense of loving God, all other elements are full. Therefore, the full attachment for Krishna is to love Him as your lover. So Krishna says, Madhasram, this yoga system, bhakti yoga, is to develop attachment for Krishna under His protection. Madhasram. Just like a friend protects his friend, a master protects his servant, a parent, a father protects his child, or a lover protects his lover. Similarly, there is some protectional element. But I swear, Krishna is my friend. He will protect me. Krishna is my master. He will protect me. Krishna is my son. He will protect me. Krishna is my lover. He will protect me. So this is called Madhatma. If you take this attitude, in either of these attitudes, either friend or lover, or son or master, like that, and you develop your attachment for Krishna, then asaṃsaya, without any doubt, samagram, incomplete, in full completeness, you can understand what is God. This is the philosophy of Krishna consciousness, that you have to take shelter of Krishna in either of these aspects, and you have to develop your attachment for either of these aspects. Then Krishna says that jnanam trihaṁ sabhijnanam idam vakṣāmi asirvatā. Now this knowledge of God is not a sentiment. It is science. It is science. This is scientific. Nobody can deny it. We are not preaching any particular type of sentiment or any broad speculation. It is fact. How our relationship with the Supreme Lord can develop, how we are related with Him, these things are fact on philosophical basis. Therefore, Krishna is assuring Arjuna that what I am talking to you is not a religious sentiment, but it is jnanam. Jnanam means it is practical knowledge. Jnanam means theoretical knowledge. And vijnanam means practical knowledge. So Krishna says, the jnanam, jnanam tehaṁ sabhijnanam. I am just speaking to you the exact knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead with practical demonstration. Just like in the laboratory, if you are a BSc student, you have to appear for practical examination, simply knowing that such and such chemical element mixed with such and such chemical element becomes such and such chemical element is theoretical knowledge. Oxygen and hydrogen mixed together produces water. This is theoretical knowledge. But when in the laboratory you actually add such and such quantity of oxygen gas, you mix with such and such quantity of hydrogen gas, at once there is formation of water. As soon as you mix alkali and acid together, there is at once reaction, evolution. So similarly, theoretical knowledge that we have got a particular type of relationship with God that you cannot deny. Anything, whatever you have got in your possession, you have got some particular relationship. Suppose you are Americans, we are Indians. So we have got some particular relationship with the state. I am Indian citizen. You are American citizen. So relationship must be there. You are sitting here. There is some relationship. Suppose my students, they have got relationship with me. I am their teacher, they are my disciple. Or if you are not my disciple, then you are audience and speaker. Must be there some relation. So, similarly, if with everything we have got some relationship, why not with God? There is. That is practical relationship. But we have forgotten. We have forgotten our relationship. And yoga means to connect, to reconnect that relationship again. That is called yoga. Yoga is not a mental speculation or for health sake. Oh, for health sake, you need not go to the yoga system. If you simply adopt the practice of sandals exercise, you can become very healthy, very strong. There is no need of good yoga is defined. Yoga means concentration of the mind towards God, towards Paramatma, which you have forgotten now. At the present moment, although you remember sometimes, there is God, but actually, due to the influence of external energy or the material energy, we have forgotten. So we have to re-establish our forgotten relationship. It is not that we have no relationship with God and we are artificially forcing something relationship with God, Krishna consciousness. No. You have your relationship simply by hearing, by cultivation of this knowledge, you revive your relationship. That's all. That's why in the matches there is fire. You simply rub it for some time, for a few seconds, or the fire will come up. Similarly, your relationship with Krishna, Krishna consciousness, is there within you. Otherwise, how could you accept the Krishna consciousness? I have imported Krishna from India. That is also a mistake. Krishna is not for India or America. Just like the sun, this is same sun which I have seen in India, the same sun is in your America. So nobody can claim, oh, this is Indian sun and this is American sun. Sun is one. It is our miscalculation that we say, this is American land, this is American sun, this is American atmosphere. No. Everything in relationship with God. That is jnana, that is knowledge. And vidyana, and practical. So Krishna says that I will explain to you, if you adopt this principle, that development of attachment to Krishna, under my protection. If you don't take the protection of Krishna, then you cannot develop attachment for Krishna. You have to accept. That development, they are explained to you that it takes place by giving something, by taking something, by disclosing something, by understanding something, by eating something, by giving Krishna to eat something, by six parts. So, Krishna says, I am speaking to you this jnanam sabhijnanam, jnanam te aham sabhijnanam idam. Sabhijnanam means with scientific knowledge. Bhakshami, I will say, just jnakta. If you try to understand this knowledge, or if you understand this knowledge, just jnakta na iha, not in this material world. Now, because in the spiritual world, there is no ignorance. Spiritual life means full of knowledge, full of bliss, eternal life. So therefore, Krishna says, that if you understand this knowledge, the knowledge of Krishna, or the science of Krishna, or the science of Krishna consciousness, jajnata na hiyaha bhuya, bhuya means again, annyat, anything more, annyat jnatavyam, understandam avasishtate derimen. That means, if you understand, as I am speaking to you, in science, practical and theoretical, if you understand this knowledge, then you will have nothing to know. There is nothing more knowable to you in this world. That means your knowledge becomes full. Jajgyatya neha bhuyad anna jnatabvam avasuchyati. Sakshakti daya vivikta sarupa visayakam jnanam vijnanam tena sahitansi tumbham prapanna asayato samagram bhakshan. Now, here Krishna says that I am speaking to you. He is particularly marking Arjuna. Why? He does not say here that I am speaking to everyone. No. Everyone cannot understand this knowledge. It is confidential. Krishna consciousness is not understandable by any ordinary man. Of course, Lord Chaitanya has made it so easy in for this age that if you sincerely, with devotion, chant Hare Krishna, you will be able to understand. But this science as it is as itself, it is very difficult. It is very difficult. But because the age is not very favorable, the time is not very favorable, therefore Lord Chaitanya has inaugurated the Sankirtan movement by chanting Hare Krishna and dancing, so that your mind very quickly becomes clear, so that you can understand what is Krishna consciousness. The simple process. Otherwise, Krishna says, it is not for us. I am speaking to you the scientific knowledge of Krishna consciousness and to you. Why? And to you. Because he is a surrendered soul. He is a surrendered soul. The beginning of Bhagavad Gita is there. You know, when Krishna was talking with Arjuna as friend, he did not talk very seriously. He was simply saying, my dear Arjuna, it is not good for you that you shall not fight. You are a Kshatriya, you belong to the warrior class, so if you don't fight, it will not be very good. This is on the basis of friendship. But Arjuna also understood that Krishna is not very seriously talking with me because we are friends. So he surrendered himself. He said that, my dear Krishna, I can understand that the problem which has arisen in this battlefield, it is a very difficult problem. I have come here to fight, but I have been disturbed with sentiments of how I can kill my brother, my teacher, my grandfather, my grandsons, and so on and so on. So, but I know also that these problems, these problematic situations which has arisen, it can be solved by you only. But since Arjuna knew it, that Krishna is not my ordinary friend, he is the Supreme Personality of God. Therefore, he at once surrendered. Shishasteham sadhimam prapanyam. I am surrendered unto you as your disciple. Please accept me and just teach me what is good for me. Therefore, Krishna also says, there is a jnanam se aham. I am speaking to this knowledge. I am speaking to you this knowledge, this confidential knowledge, because you are surrendered.